performing with Maestro Pappano is a warm and jubilating experience. You don't have a worry in the world. Nothing is happening, only the music. When I performed with Maestro Pappano in Santa Cecilia, the Schumann Concerto, at the BBC Proms in 2013, I recall that I didn't even feel slightly nervous before going out on stage, which is quite incredible, performing for 5,000 people and live TV and live radio, and not having this emotion. That's only thanks to Maestro Pappano, because this love, essentially, that he exudes on stage, the love of the music, the love of performing, makes you feel happy and at peace, and you want to play your best for him and for the orchestra and for yourself. And that translates also for playing your best for the audience. Thank you, Maestro Pappano. Traditionally, Schumann Concerto is paired with Grieg's Concerto, and it's a very strong and well-recorded pairing. But I wanted to show two pieces that aren't frequently played, aren't frequently recorded, but stand up for themselves. It has so many colors and so many avenues that I think a CD only with Schumann's music can be strong and can say a lot. And I think it also gives the audience a different perspective on the very well-known concerto. Hearing it paired with Schumann's own pieces, and also keeping in mind that Schumann very nearly didn't finish the concerto. He almost would have left it in the same one movement form that we have for the other two pieces. I think shows how important this form was to him, and I'm very glad that we could include it on the CD as well. Schumann's introduction and concert Allegro, Opus 134, is a piece that's rarely performed, quite rarely recorded, and in fact has never been recorded in Deutsche Grammophon's history. I'm not sure what the reasons are why it's not in Deutsche Grammophon's catalog, but why it's programmed rarely can stem to the fact that it's a challenging piece to wrap your mind around. At the time when I was learning it, I had no idea of the historical context, but immediately I felt as if the emotions were raw and unbridled. They were exposed to you, and somehow you had to get on the bull and control it. It wasn't something that was already prepackaged. And knowing the historical context, I can now understand why. Schumann, while he originally dedicated the piece to Clara, his wife, later changed the dedication to Johannes Brahms. He was going through a strenuous part of his life. Soon after, he committed himself to a mental asylum and also tried to take his own life. Certainly, you can feel this pain and suffering and yearning and searching in this music. It'll go from one extreme to another, and I think there's everything from the love for Clara, his wife, to the incredible emotions that must have made him try to take his life. Everything is in this piece. Traumerei on the CD, because I always wish to record CDs as if I would perform live. I want to retain that feeling of being in a concert hall. As an encore, I always love playing something that's reflective, that's silent, that gives the audience a moment to firm up their memories of the performance, to somehow retain them within themselves, and give them a moment of reflection. So Traumerei is like a thank you, and a good night, and a goodbye, and until next time, everything into one, beyond being also a beautiful piece by itself.